Hey guys, you're watching the Let's Go G Show. I'm your host, Kelsey Schaneville. Let's dive right into it with some women's golf action as the Spartans hosted the Starmount Fall Classic this week. Women's golf finished in fourth place, marking their third straight top 10 finish to open the season. Freshman Tara Bettle led four Spartans to top 20 finishes individually with a career best ninth place. On October 9th and 10th, they will play in the Pinehurst Challenge. Volleyball started off conference play on the road with ETSU in Chattanooga, and this past weekend played Mercer and Sanford at home. Right now, they have a 2-2 conference record, and Christina Gregory says the conference is wide open.
The SoCon playing is just very all over the place. I think teams are doing better than they thought, and I think teams that thought that they were at the top aren't at the top still. So I think every team in the SoCon has a good chance of winning, and definitely our team is up there for sure.
Gregory earned her second SoCon Defensive Player of the Week award of the season and her fifth of her career this week. She recorded 17 digs against Mercer on Friday night and then went for an impressive 32 digs against Sanford.
Well, what's allowing Christina Gregory to get defensive awards is Christina Gregory. You know, she's a really great defensive player. She's established herself as such in our league. You know, that was one of the things that really stood out to us for her in the recruiting process. And so it's not really a surprise. But it's really cool that you can see a young lady perform at her potential and bring so much to our team. We really appreciate her fight and her grit, and that's been a key component for her success and for ours.
Volleyball is back in action tomorrow night when they start the weekend off playing Wofford and then Furman. Their next home game won't be until October 13th versus the Citadel. Women's soccer has started their conference playoffs strong with a 2-1-1 record and has already doubled the amount of goals they've scored before conference play in half the amount of games. They now have scored 8 goals in 4 games.
We've got so many new players. It takes a while to get used to each other. So the fact that we're now into this stage of the season, they've had weeks to get used to each other as opposed to days leading into the Florida States and the Clemsons of the world. So now we're actually understanding where people go when they go to places on the field and why they go there and how we can actually really take advantage of their movement.
Two players who have really stood out for the Spartans are Emily Jensen and Haida Viedersdotter.
Contributions to this team have been tremendous, and not just from the points getting and the goal scoring and assists that they've got, but also the fact that they're starting players and they're both real leaders. And they're both really, really liked by their teammates, which is vitally important.
Women's soccer will hit the road to play Sanford and Chattanooga this weekend and will be back at UNCG on October 15th to play VMI. As for the men's team, they tied their first SoCon matchup against ETSU and pulled a 2-0 win against conference rival Furman. More recently, they fell to Wofford on Tuesday, making their record 1-1-1. Justin Mullen told me what he's looking for from his team moving forward.
Yeah, we want to continue to defend. Obviously, we'd like to score more goals. You know, last year we led every category on the attacking side of things. This year we're leading every category on the defensive side of things. But that's a good sign because the defending wins championships. But really, we'd like to score more goals.
As Coach said, there's been a lot of success on the defensive side for UNCG this season. Goalkeeper John Milligan has been a huge part of that.
You know, obviously, anytime you're getting that amount of shutouts, you've got to look at your goalkeeper. But for us, it starts from the top. You know, we defend with our front three, then our middle three, and then our back four. So, but the back four in front of him have been very, very good. But take nothing away from John. You know, he's been excellent for us.
The team is back on the road visiting Georgia when they play Mercer, and will be back at home on October 14th to play ETSU for the second time this season. For more on men's soccer, stick around for a story on how two players' relationships on and off the field helps them reach their goals.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you.
In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it.
Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Add big flavor to your next get-together with Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices. All made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle Southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360-CATER or visit subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater fresh.
Teammates. Far from home. friendship. These are just a few of the words that describe the relationship between Leroy Magarache and Matt Mattis. Leroy Magarache and Matt Mattis both attend the University of North Carolina at Greensboro. The two grew up across the pond in England, Matt in Littlestoke and Leroy in Milton Keynes. They also each had their fair share of success. Matt was playing up a few age groups for the U21 Bristol City squad, and Leroy was helping lead Stantonbury campus to a national runner-up finish.
I played up until the under-18 age group, but I always played up in the under-21s in my last 2 years at City. And I felt like that helped my development as a player as well, as the physicality. It's a lot more in the under-21s, so I'm playing against like professional players.
It was good because we were able to play like a lot of players who are at like bigger clubs already now. So it was a very good exposure. I was able to test myself and my team was able to do that as well.
I knew I wanted to come over to the US after I finished my scholarship at Bristol City. I got together like a promotional like video, sent it to a few coaches over here, and Justin was actually the first coach to contact me back. I felt like this was the best fit for me.
Leroy was able to play in a showcase exhibition in which numerous college coaches from across the US attended, one being Justin Mullen in UNCG.
Justin and Scott, who was here, they flew over to England and watched me play. And a couple of days after, Justin rang me up and he offered me to come here. I don't know, I felt like he knew me already, the way he spoke to me, and like he spoke to my parents, and we were all like for it, so I made my decision to come here.
Far from home, Leroy and Matt both had to adjust to an entirely new culture across the pond.
I was happy that I had someone else from England, so like I found him as a brother really, so I could relate back to him. And
it was nice to have someone kind of familiar, you know, from the same sort of area as you.
We hang out a lot. We've been roommates since freshman year, so we just do a lot of stuff together and like try to see new things and stuff like that, as well as with our other teammates, and they help us in terms of adjusting to the culture and just being around.
I mean, even the little things like the food, even like the portion size of the food. In Europe, you like you don't get the same amount of food like as you do here.
And like the different like shops you guys have and different restaurants I've never seen before.
Even like some of the language that we use in the UK is different to like here. And like, I remember when I first came here, when I'd say thank you for something, someone would respond like, mm-hmm. And like, that's something that we don't say in the UK. And like, just little things like that, I was like, I always thought like, what does that mean? And then after a while I got used to it. And like saying like small things like cheers when I say thank you for stuff, people kind of look at me weird like, what's he saying cheers?
During their time together, one match stands out in their minds.
I remember it like it was yesterday.
Our first game here at UNCG against Virginia Tech.
I was so like nervous coming into the game, like I didn't know what to expect.
And I remember in the UK it's different, like if it's a tie and not after 90 minutes, like it's a tie.
So after 90 minutes, me and Matt were walking off the pitch, and then Justin was like, we still got 20 more minutes to go.
And then he scored in overtime. And then everyone was celebrating and everyone was walking off the pitch, and I thought that the game was going to carry on and stuff. And no, I think that was a quite a surreal experience, and a memory that I shared with him.
Leroy and Matt's relationship is one that goes well beyond the pitch.
You know, some of the low times of being homesick out here, he's helped me through a lot of those times. And I'd like to say that I've helped him as well, so our friendship means a lot.
It's meant the world really, because I was able to come with someone straight away from England, and he made me feel welcome here, and as well as I made him feel welcome here.
Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you tune in to our next episode and follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And remember, don't be blue, be blue and gold.